G'day, my name's Gordon Dedman and welcome to another episode of Bushcraft Survival. Today we're going to be looking at how to make natural cordage using the cabbage tree palm and the spiny headed mat rush. Now, along with a knife, some means of making fire, a metal container, and a covering or shelter of some description, one of the top essential five items we need to have as part of any good survival kit is cordage. Now, along with the other four items, if you don't have cordage in your kit already, you need to find some way of manufacturing that in nature. And that's what we're going to have a look at today. The Australian Aborigines have been using natural fibre to make cordage with for thousands of years. There are numerous species of plants and trees that we can use to make natural cordage. And one of the best is the cabbage tree palm. Its botanical name is Livistona australis. Now, the cabbage tree palm is like the supermarket of the bush. Other than cordage, we can use it for shelter building, for fire lighting, and for food. There are a couple of different sections of the cabbage tree palm we could use for cordage. One is the actual leaf stem itself, and we'll be having a look at that a little later. The other is the unopened leaf fronds. And as you can see, I pull those apart and we've got our leaf fronds that are unopened. And we're going to be using those. Now, I can harvest this from this plant and it's not going to hurt the tree at all. We only take what we need and just one of those. So I'm going to get my saw, because if I use my saw, I'm just going to leave a nice smooth cut, so it's not going to damage the tree in any way. So I'm going to cut that down right at the base. And in this one section, we have our leaf stem. We're going to be able to harvest cordage from the leaf stem here, and that makes tremendous cordage. It's more like wire. And we're going to be able to make cordage from the unopened leaf fibres as well. We're going to have a look at how to do that. Okay, here are our leaf stems. In order to get those out, I just simply pull them apart. You can see we've got cordage at the end there already. I'm just going to grab a couple of these to show you. That's all we need to do for now. Now, these are almost like a book. They have a spine and two leaves per spine. All we have to do is open them up and we just separate those. Just a single leaf, we open it up, it has a spine running along the back. We're just opening that up like that. Ideally, what I want to do is split those in two, and that's what we're going to use for our cordage. Now, with any sort of cordage, one of the most important parts and the most time consuming is getting all your strips of fibre prepared ahead of time, and crucially, it's very important that you get them all the same thickness and the same diameter, because then when we make our cordage later, we're going to find we're going to get a nice even twist. If you have one section that's thicker than another or thinner than another, it's just going to wrap around the other strand. So it's very, very important that when we have these laid out, we've got them all at a universal size and thickness. So that's what the splitting's doing. And what I like to do is just simply, we can split this by hand, but I find it's a little bit more accurate if I use my knife. I just put my knife in the center and just simply pull that through. And you'll be amazed at how these shrink. These will shrink up quite small. I'll just do a couple more. Sometimes they don't split as well as you'd like. Come back to that one. And if I wanted to, I could actually split those yet again. Okay, as we can see, I have quite a few strips there, and they're all pretty much exactly the same thickness. They all taper at the end too, and that's very important, because when we're actually splicing in new sections, we want them to taper, and it actually makes for a nice even join. So all we need to do is wait a couple of days for these to dry, and they're going to actually shrivel up considerably, and then they're going to be great to make cordage with. But if we wanted to use some cordage immediately, we could. This is actually, we can use that as a rough cordage straight away, and that's quite strong. If we wanted something a little bit thinner, the actual spine of these leaves makes like a great wire. And I'm just going to split just that spine out for you. And that's like a little bit of wire, and that's quite strong, and that's actually great for tying up shelters when we're building shelters and things like that. That works wonderfully just for tying little things together, and we get that same type of strength from the stem itself. And if we were to take sections of the stem off, we find that they're very, very strong. And we can use that like a woodsman's wire. That works wonderfully, and that is quite strong. So there's a ready-to-use wire straight away. And that's just taken from the stem. And literally, I could probably at least get 10 strips like that from this stem. So there's two different forms of cordage there as well. If I wanted to as well, actually there's some that are just peeling off there nicely. I'm getting cordage and nice fibers from that. I could peel a nice flat strip off there if I wanted something a little bit wider. So just from the stem we can get bits of wire like that which are ready to go cordage straight away. And what we're going to do, we're going to take our strips from the inner unopened leaves. We've broken those down into their correct lengths and widths, and we're now going to wait about 2 days for these to dry. Once they're dry, they would have shrunk considerably, and then we're going to look at how to actually make cordage with those. Well, it's been a couple of days, and we've allowed our inner fronds of the palm leaves to dry, but unfortunately it's been wet the entire time, so they haven't dried and shrunk as much as I would like. However, we can still make cordage out of these. It is a little bit better if they're dry. Now, there are two main methods of making cordage. The first one involves twisting. So I take my frond and I bend it so it's not quite in half. I don't want it in half. I need to have it offset, because when we add in our new strands, we don't want the adding the new fibres in at the same place, or that's going to weaken and create a weak spot in our cordage. So we want to make sure it's offset. I grip the end of our bend, and then gripping the top part, I grip, I twist away from myself, rotate under, pinch the bottom strand to my finger, then all of those I twist towards myself. I let go. I grab the two, twist under, clamp, twist them all back towards myself. Twist away, clamp, twist back towards myself. Away, clamp, toward myself. Away, clamp, toward myself. And once it's done fast, you can do that. Now, inevitably, you come to the end of a strand at some point. At this point, we take another strand, and this is why we taper them at each end. We want them tapered so that we so when we join, they're not too thick together, otherwise we're going to create a thick spot. So all I do is I lay one across the other like that. Then, as before, I just grab those two together and I twist as before. Grabbing the two together, rotating away, clamp, rotate back towards yourself. Away, clamp, back towards. Grab, twist away, clamp, and back towards yourself. And then I carry on as before. Now I've come to the end of our second strand. I take once again another strand, ensuring that it's tapered. I lie that across. Gripping the two, I carry on before. Rotate away, clamp, back towards myself. Just making sure that you're grabbing the correct two strands and not mixing them up. So you need to keep an eye on that. So here's a look at our cordage so far. We've added two inner strand, or two different strands, and we carry on for the length of cordage that we need to make, or that we have resources to make, or that we have the patience to make. And that's the reverse ply twisting method of making cordage. We're going to have a look at another method now called the rolling method. But in order to show you that, I need to put some shorts on because we need it against the bare skin, because a lot of pants, these pants are just too slippery to roll it against my legs. So I'm going to have to get into some shorts. Well, we've had a look at one method of making cordage using the reverse ply twist. We're going to have a look at the second method, which involves rolling the cord on our leg. And as you can see, I've changed into some shorts because it's just too difficult to try and do that on smooth pants. You can't get any grip. And Aboriginal women, when they made cordage, they would do it on a bare thigh. All the time they did on a bare thigh. So you get a much greater purchase from bare skin. However, if you've got hairy legs, it can pinch a bit. So what we need to do, we take a strand, once again, remembering that we've got them all tapered towards one end. And just to start that off, I'm just going to roll that to get that used to rolling. Okay. And as before, I'm going to get my strand and I'm going to bend it in the center, but this time I'm going to offset it, because that, like the twisting method, we don't want the two joints to be in the same place, or that's going to weaken the strength of the cordage. We want to offset that. So once I have them there, I then place that the strands parallel on my thigh. With my right hand, I then clamp them down on my leg and then roll away from myself, ensuring that these two are rolling together and at the same time. Rotating away, as you can see they're both twisting. I then let go of my left hand. And as you can see, that naturally tries to twist up. So I encourage that a little, and then move up to where that finished rolling. I then put it on my thigh, I clamp again, pushing away from myself rolling till they don't want to roll any further. I let go, and then I encourage that and twist up, and then I just repeat the process. You have to make sure that both strands roll evenly. Give that one more. And as you can see, we've got some nice strong cordage from the rolling method. That was a lot quicker. Another part of the cabbage tree palm which is great for cordage making is the palm fibre itself. Now, we've already looked at this in other episodes, and the palm fibre makes a great tinder for fire lighting. You have to be careful when you harvest this, because there's lots of spines and spikes on the leaves, and they can give you a nasty prick. Wonderful for tinder, but equally as good for making cordage. Well, here we have our palm fibre from the cabbage tree. As well as making great tinder for fire lighting, it also makes wonderful cordage. In French Polynesia, a lot of the islanders actually use coconut husk in a very similar method to what I'm going to show you now. First of all, we just get some small strands of this. Don't need too much. And the idea is we're trying to make a thin sausage. We're trying to roll this into a thin sausage. The thinner you make the sausage, the thinner your cordage. Likewise, the thicker your sausage, the thicker the cordage is going to be. Once again, like all cordage making, it's all the preparation before you actually make the cordage which takes the most time. So I'm just creating a sausage here. Now what I want to do is try and make it as long as I can, because then it's going to require less splicing later. However, it's inevitable that you're going to have to do any splicing. I've got some thick bits here, so I just tease that out. I try to get that, we want that as close to the one thickness as possible. I've got any thin bits, I'm just going to get a little bit of fibre, stick it over the thin bits, and I'll just roll that in. Any thicker bits, I'll take it from there. So we're not making cordage yet. We're just preparing our strand. So I get that as even a sausage as I can. We want it as even as possible, because if it's not even, you'll find that the thinner strand will always wrap around the thicker one. So it's very important to try and get them as close to the strand as the same thickness as possible right throughout the entire length. Now we're ready to turn that into some cordage. First thing we do, we get our sausage. Now, unlike the other methods of cordage where we have to offset them so they're not in the middle, because we can just add in fibre very easily when we get to the end, it's not so crucial. So I'm going to bend this in the middle, gripping with my left hand. I grip the top strand with my finger and thumb and I rotate away from myself. I rotate away from myself. My finger comes under, pinches the bottom strand to the top finger, then I rotate all of those together back towards myself. My left hand moves up. I grab, twist away from myself. Little finger comes under, pinches. Then I rotate them all towards myself. Grab, away, pinch, towards myself. Have to make sure they don't bundle up. Pinch, roll, pinch, back towards yourself. And a little bit faster, it looks like this. Now, I've just gone to the end. And as you can see, we have some cordage. Our two strands, all we need to do from there is get some more palm fibre and simply roll them into the sausage. Each sausage, you've got two sausages, roll them in there, and then we just continue on as before. So you need to wait until you've got about this much and then start adding more fibre to your sausage, two sausages, and then we carry on as before, twisting around. And that's how you make cordage with palm fibre. It is possible to roll it, as in the other method. However, with this, because it's more of a fibrous type of cordage, I find that it works better this way. It tends to, you get a much tighter twist, and it seems to hold together a lot better than the rolling method.